In pre-trib theology, there are three key texts that pre-tribbers use to prove their doctrine, namely 1 Thessalonians 4:13 to 18, 1 Corinthians 15:51 to 52, and John 14:1 to 3. As I have already covered the first two texts, I will unveil two probable views how John 14:1 to 3 should be interpreted in this and the next video. Though only one of them can be true, both views are still better placed than the one that is put forward by Joseph Prince and the pre-tribbers.
You know what, Jesus? Look at them, and Jesus says in the upper room, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." You're about to find the key to having a heart that is not troubled. Are you ready? "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." Now this is spoken to the church. "In my Father's house are many mansions." He didn't say, "In my Father's house are many huts." Mansions. "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. I will come again and receive you to myself. I will come again and receive you to myself." This is the rapture. Are you listening? All right? "That where I am, there you may be also." For the first time, Jesus unveiled to them a rapture. People call it secret rapture. You can call it what you want. Yes, it is for his own.
John 14:1 to 3 is one of the most misunderstood passages in the Bible. In the days when the King James Version was written, a mansion was understood to be just a room and not a huge and extravagant house like we understand today. That is why today, most translations translated the passage more pertinently as "many dwelling places" or "many rooms" instead of "mansions." It seems that Joseph Prince is still living in the past, still thinking about mansions because of his health and wealth theology, when many have moved on to rooms and dwelling places. In the upper room, Jesus told his disciples that he must go away to prepare a place for them. Yet, this has nothing to do with Jesus going to heaven to build mansions for them, as taught by Joseph Prince and pre-tribbers. First, heaven is not even mentioned once in the text and the whole chapter. Second, as I shall cover in the next video, Father's house is never used as a term in Scripture to describe heaven. So, in context, Jesus going is not to go to heaven to prepare a place for them. His going is specifically to prepare a place for them, referred primarily to the crucifixion. Since this discourse took place the night before the crucifixion, it seems natural that Jesus was preparing the disciples for what will happen the following day. Jesus was preparing the disciples for the events of the following day by foretelling the crucifixion. As you read John 14:1 to 3 within its context, you will see that Jesus was speaking of his going away to the cross to redeem mankind. In the larger context of John chapter 13, immediately preceding the passage in question in chapter 14, Jesus going away meant going to the cross. This is strongly implied in Jesus' remark to Peter about his impending denial. In John 13:36, Jesus told Peter that he could not follow him yet, but that he would follow him afterwards. This is most likely a reference to Peter's martyrdom that Jesus foretold in John 21:18 to 19. Since Jesus told Peter he could not follow him now, but would follow him later, his going away is certainly referring to his crucifixion. Jesus first spoke of going away in chapter 13, And then again, at the beginning of chapter 14, he's going to prepare a place for you, should be understood within this context. So where was Jesus going? Jesus was going to the cross to prepare the way of salvation for them. Joseph Prince and Pre-Tribers teach that Christ is going away to heaven to prepare mansions for his disciples and then to take them from earth to heaven at the rapture. But this is never stated in the text, as both the words heaven and rapture are totally absent from the text. They have once again read into the text in order to prove their doctrine. Jesus was consoling his disciples about his going away in John 14:1. He explained that his going away will work to their advantage, as he will prepare the dwelling places where they can experience his ever-abiding presence. This will be accomplished by his obedience to die on the cross and achieve the salvation of mankind. Once a believer is saved and in Christ, he will experience the ever-presence of Jesus and his Father by constantly dwelling in their presence. No wonder Jesus in John 14:23 says, "We will come to him and make our dwelling place with him." When we cross-reference this with John 14:2, when Jesus says, "In my Father's house are many dwelling places," we can now understand that Jesus wasn't referring to heaven, but to an abiding relationship we can have with both the Father and him. Some Psalms describe God himself as our dwelling place. Psalm 91, "Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations." Psalm 91:9, "If you say the Lord is my refuge and you make the Most High your dwelling." In other words, God's house or dwelling place is wherever God is and wherever his presence is manifest. If we go one step further and refer to the many references in John 14:18 to 21 and 15:4 to 10, which stresses the disciples' abiding relationship with Christ, we can be sure that the dwelling places is not to live in mansions in the sky, but experiencing a constant and abiding spiritual union with Christ and his Father. Now we can understand why Jesus said, "I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also." But Jesus didn't say, "I will receive you to myself so that I can take you to the mansions in heaven." No one should ever deny that there is a literal heaven. Yet, in the immediate context of John 14:1 to 3, and the larger context of John chapters 13 to 17, what Jesus is talking about is not heaven, but the spiritual relationship to the Father through our union with Christ, because of what Christ has done for us on the cross. Last, and in summary, let me close the loop by bringing in John 14:4 to 7 as part of the whole context. To Thomas' question that they don't know where Jesus is going in verses 2, 3, and 4, "So how can they know the way?" Jesus replied that he is the way to the Father. So Jesus, by bringing them to the Father, doesn't mean he is going to bring them to heaven at the rapture. What Jesus is driving at is that they don't have to wait much longer to know the Father. They can know him right in the here and now, because Jesus said, "If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Jesus wasn't speaking about bringing us to heaven where there are many mansions to house us. Instead, Jesus was stating that By his death on the cross, he has prepared a place for us to be with the Father, in order that we can enjoy a close and abiding relationship with him. Such a close relationship with both the Father and Jesus can be enjoyed in the here and now on earth. Once Christ has accomplished the work of salvation on the cross for us. Hence, Joseph Prince and the Pre-Tribus view that John 14, 1-3 is about Jesus taking believers to heaven in the rapture to escape tribulation is out of context and cannot be accepted.